Yeah, we'll get back. Hope all of you have rejoined. See, now I was trying to tell you about the particular symptoms. Okay. See, now when we talk of particular symptoms, again, I had made it very clear, we'll directly start with one second. Okay, one of your friend wants to know that sometimes people would have students would have prepared very well in exams, and once they see the paper, they forget things. See, now colchicum will not fit into that situation. Okay, see, there are plenty of remedies, and as a second year student, you are just getting introduced to remedies. Okay, so materia medica is a very vast subject, right? Slowly keep adding. Now today I've told you colchicum, tomorrow somebody might tell you some other remedy. Try to keep the situations in mind and you can start applying accordingly. But not every patient who the moment he sees the paper, he forgets, you can't think of colchicum blindly for every person. Colchicum is one of the remedies, but if there are remedies, other remedies which fits better, then you may have to think of other remedies. Colchicum is one remedy. Yes, there's nothing wrong. Okay. So hope that part is clear. Now, before I start, what do you expect under the gastric affections of colchicum? Now, I know you are second year students. I keep telling you repeatedly. Now, slowly you should start cultivating the habit of contributing, understanding, thinking. Okay. Now the particular symptoms when we are talking of, now this component, if you have to understand better, you should know the knowledge of anatomy, you should know the knowledge of physiology, and now that you are getting introduced to pathology, you should also know the knowledge of pathology. And of course, forensic medicine is also a beautiful subject, the knowledge of which we can borrow to understand materia medica better. So that's what I keep insisting all my students. Materia, if you read it alone as a subject, it will be very boring. You have to use your analytical mind, apply the different subjects that you are studying, then materia medica becomes very, very interesting. Okay. So particular symptoms, our symptoms generally we look, you know, we don't give much importance. But if you learn the art of understanding particular symptoms, then particular symptoms will be equally interesting and it will be equally challenging. Okay. Now we'll apply all what I'm trying to tell you here so that you get a better picture of colchicum. See, when I say GIT, from the anatomy knowledge, you should first think of which organs come under GIT. See, when I say GIT, you can't tell something related to respiratory or something related to some other system. Though sometimes they might be interrelated. But when I say GIT, from the knowledge of anatomy, you should know it starts from the lips and it ends with the anal canal. So now start understanding. Keep the sphere of action in your mind, keep the characteristic symptoms in your mind, and just try to fit in. What are all the things that might come under GIT? So can I have some quick inputs? I know a few of you have already started contributing. Somebody said nausea, very good, nausea, good. So there is nausea, absolutely fine. Anything else that you can think of apart from nausea? Okay. Now, when you talk of nausea, nausea can be a general thing. Now, when do you indicate colchicum in nausea will become very, very important. So, what is it that is special about colchicum in nausea? I have told you all this. So, what is special? Yes, very good, beautiful, good. Yeah. So, nausea, not only at the sight, not only at the smell, even at the thought, you think about food, cooked food, you start, you know, nauseating. You start nauseating. So very, very important. The smell in colchicum is very sensitive. The olfactory nerve is very, very sensitive. It is oversensitive, right? So they react very badly to smell. So nausea at the sight and smell of food, very good, absolutely right. And sometimes they might even vomiting, they might even vomit. There might be a lot of retching, whack, whack, fine. That's what we call it as retching. So I have also had a small text I've just typed so that this gives you some more clarity and you don't miss on those things. So nausea, sensitive to odor, sensitive to smell. Not only nausea, not only vomiting. In colchicum, the olfactory nerve is so sensitive that they might even faint. So fainting from odor, very unusual, very characteristic. If you come across some person tomorrow who faints just smelling, you can think of colchicum. Smell of food, especially cooked food. And to be more precise, smell of fish causes a lot of problems in colchicum. Vomiting of bile, vomiting of mucus and food. So this is what you see in the stomach. This is what you see in the stomach. Anything else that you can think of in stomach, in colchicum? Anything else you can think of in stomach, in colchicum is the question. Waiting for your answers. Okay, good. Ulcers, good. Ulcers, but in colchicum, you may not see ulcers here. You see more of inflammation, more of gastritis. Good. There might be burning sensation. Okay. See, now one more component or one more thing as a second year student, you should remember is desires and aversions. What is it? Desires and aversions will also come under stomach. Okay. So whenever you have desires and aversions in a remedy, and when we are discussing the stomach part, please include those. Okay. Now, the next question will be, what are the desires of colchicum? Very good. Desires for mustard. Good. Desires for mustard. Okay. Coffee. Good. Beautiful. Cold things. Yes, wine. Yeah. Somebody has given all the four. Wine, coffee, mustard, cold things. Good. Beautiful. Keep it up. So, desires can also be included here under the stomach. So GIT, you'll be concentrating on that nausea, that sensitiveness to odor, that retching, vomiting. What brings on nausea? That inflammation, gastritis, burning, and of course the desires. Okay. So this is, now you'll have to imagine the anatomy of GIT. Though I don't have an image here, please visualize. We spoke of stomach. Now lower down, we are talking of the abdomen. We are talking of the abdomen. So what do you expect? Burning and icy coldness in stomach and abdomen. Now what do you expect under abdomen? Very good distension. Now before we take off, very good distension, somebody is talking of scraping of intestines, beautiful. It's a nice point, valid point. Very good, bloating. Okay, now before I talk of the abdominal part, see, there's one thing I missed and I thought I should tell you. They crave a lot of things. See, mind wants them to eat many things. But, you know, food is something which will give you aroma, which will give you a smell. But that smell will cause an aversion to them. Though they are hungry, they want to eat a lot of varieties of food. You know, when the food is served, the smell says, no, 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 I don't want to eat this. One more thing specifically they have a disagreement is, one more thing that they will not like here is eggs. Eggs disagree in colchicum. You have the image there. So we'll come to the abdominal part. And before I take up the kidneys, we'll again try to revise so that this gets solidly rooted in your mind. Now we'll talk of the abdominal symptoms. The abdomen, somebody rightly said distension. Can we, yeah, beautiful, Ashwini, this is what I wanted. Feels as if the abdomen would burst. there can be inflammation of the what intestines, colitis, okay, and there can be distension of abdomen, gas, gassy feeling in abdomen. They feel it will burst, okay, and anything else that you can think of in colchicum. Just use your common sense. Just use the anatomy. Go back to the sphere of action. See if you can link something else. See if you can link something else. What was the action of colchicum on heart? What did I tell you? What did I tell you? Acting on heart, what will colchicum do? What is the action of colchicum on heart? Sphere of action, very good. Okay, very good. Pericarditis. So what you also have to understand, when I'm talking to you about abdomen, reflecting your anatomy knowledge, colchicum is also a very good remedy for ascites. It has an affinity for serous membranes and it will cause effusion. It will cause accumulation of fluid. So one more important area or one more important condition where colchicum might get indicated will be ascites. The image will come next. So we'll keep ascites aside for time being. In abdomen, one more symptom that you can think of here is colic. See, colic, being a second year student, must be would have heard this for the first time. Colic is pain related to the intestines. Colicky pain, we say. So colchicum is also a remedy for colic, abdominal colic. Colic, the moment they eat, they feel colicky pains, and colicky pains better by bending double. Colicky pains better by bending double. In bracket, I have given you a few more remedies which you should remember, which has colic better by bending double. One important remedy will be colocynth, and hopefully next class colocynth is the remedy that I'll be discussing. So you can go through colocynth and it will be easy for us to interact better. Okay, so let me finish colchicum, and then if colchicum is clear, we can start with colocynth. So under abdomen, three things minimum you should remember as a second year student: that distension of abdomen, that feeling as if abdomen would burst, first thing, colicky pains, and what aggravates or what increases colicky pains will be eating, and bending double ameliorates colic. Okay, now I told you I told you about another very important condition, and that is accumulation of fluid in the this thing, like, you know, the sac, okay, peritoneum. So peritoneum. Okay, so ascites, remember. Can you think of any other remedies as a second year student? Any remedies that you can think of for ascites? I don't know how many remedies are over, okay, but you should know, you should start accumulating. Very good, Madhusudan, Apis mellifica, beautiful remedy for ascites, a second year topic. Okay, apocynum is another remedy. When you have contributed apis, apocynum should come close to it. Okay, so the last area now, if you visualize, stomach is over, we spoke of the intestines, we spoke of the abdomen, now we are talking of the rectal complaints. This we have already discussed. Very good. Neeraja says dysentery. Beautiful. Nice word. Very appropriate word related to this slide. Dysentery. Can we go further? What is the character of dysentery in colchicum? We have discussed this. What is the character of, yes, very good, mucoid. Beautiful. Can somebody describe the mucoid dysentery in colchicum? Very good. Now somebody is again, Prapula is coming with white mucus. Good. But what is it that I want, or what is it that will qualify colchicum? Okay, it is frequent, Nisha, good, great. But what is it that is very important? Stools like scraping of intestines. White mucus, jelly like stools, like scraping of intestines. There will be blood, there will be mucus. One very important symptom in colchicum is it will be associated with a lot of pain and frequent urging. So that we use it as tenesmus. Okay, we call it as tenesmus. White mucus like scraping of intestines, dysentery alternating with rheumatism. Okay, dysentery alternating with rheumatism. Yes, unsatisfactory stools, frequent stools, and painful stools. If you see the expression of this image, he's got a lot of discomfort, he's got a lot of pain, and he has to frequently keep going and coming. Frequent painful urging. We call it as tenesmus. Okay. Now, before I take up this, a quick revision. What did you understand? Now, this is a very common question that will come up in your exams. Describe the gastric symptoms of colchicum. Okay. Or even in your practice, you may use this remedy very often. Okay. So, what did you understand in the gastric area? What were the gastric symptoms that you understood? Can I have a quick revision so that I am clear that you have followed this, and then I can go to the next component. So what all you understood? You can start typing. So see, go very systematic. Don't start with a jelly-like stool. Don't go from behind. That's why your anatomy, knowledge of anatomy becomes very, very important. Go very systematic. Mouth, we didn't see much. Throat also, we didn't see much. So slowly we are going into the stomach part. So try and start answering there. It will be systematic and you'll not forget. Good, nausea, vomiting, sensitiveness to smell, the desires, the aversions. Good, very good. And then we spoke of the bloating of abdomen. Okay, and then we spoke of colic pain. Yes, we spoke of ascites, and then the last part is the rectum, wherein we spoke of dysentery, stools aggravated during autumn, dysentery alternating with rheumatism. Okay, very good. So I understand that this part is clear. So I'll go ahead with the kidney affections. Now here again you can start contributing, because I have already given. What do you expect under the kidneys? What do you see in colchicum? First word that should come here is inflammation. Okay, if you remember, we are talking of nephritis. Very good. Then what else? Okay, there can be pain in the renal area because of nephritis. What else? Okay, gout, good. But gout, I'll put it under joints, though kidneys play a very important role. Okay, what else under kidneys? What is it, that image that I showed you? What happens when there is nephritis? Beautiful, good. Smita has got the point. This is what is very, very important. Because of the kidneys getting affected, because of the inflammation, the urine formation is also getting affected. Urine is dark, scanty, and inky urine. Yes, very good. Hematuria, dark, inky urine. This is a question they ask in your exams for 3 marks. Mention the urine of colchicum, or list the urinary affections of colchicum. Simple. If you write this dark, inky urine, you will get 3 marks. Okay? Nephritis, urine offensive, scanty, dark, inky, you will get 3 marks. Okay? So, albuminous urine, somebody told pain, yes. Smell is also there, offensive smell. 3 mark question. Can be of great importance even in your practice. Now the last area. Now the last area. This is something that you can again contribute. Now, what joint affections does colchicum get indicated? There are a few questions also. I'll just go through the questions after I finish this. We'll take up the questions. Yes, Amrita says arthritis. Can I have something else? Yes, beautiful Priyanka, wandering pains. Okay, good. Affects minor joints. Good, beautiful. That's also there. And now here you can use gout. Here you can use gout. So joint affections. Anything else that you'd like to contribute? I will be happy to listen from you, because I want you to, yeah, beautiful, very good. Neeraja, patient screams if you touch that part. Now, can you link it with something that we have already discussed? Neeraja, can you link this with something that we have already discussed? Why do they, the moment you touch, yeah, see, more than sensitive to touch, they are sensitive to pain. We saw under mind when I described one of the important sensitivity, same image I put there also, so that you can understand better. One of the important sensitivity in colchicum is they're very, very sensitive to pain. They scream with pain. Okay. So gout, osteoarthritis or arthritis in general, and pain which is unbearable, pain which keeps moving from one joint to another joint. Somebody has used the word wandering pains. Very good. That is the right word. Anything else in that we have in joint affections of colchicum? See now, pains which goes from one side to another side. What your books tell is pains which goes from left to right. Okay. Pain starts on the left side of the joint, left side of your body. Left knee joint might be affected first, followed by the right knee joint. So left followed by right. Okay. And they keep moving. Yes, very good. Chinmayi. She has also given you a remedy, which is very, very important remedy. Whenever we have symptoms which goes from left to right, we never think of colchicum, but we always think of one remedy, and that is the remedy Chinmayi has contributed, and that remedy is Lachesis. Very good, Lachesis. Good. Okay, so this is gout. This is what you see here, gout. Okay, very important remedy. I told you, even today allopaths, they use colchicin. It is abused for gout. Okay, so a very good remedy for gout. They can't bear to be touched. Somebody, one student already contributed, sensitive to touch. They can't move their great toe. They have difficulty in walking. Okay, and rheumatism associated with flatulence, nausea. Rheumatism alternates with what? Rheumatism alternates with dysentery. Okay, and few more things we have here under the joints. Rheumatism alternating with sedimentous and offensive urine. See, now this point you'll have to remember. Once the patient passes sedimentous urine, his joint complaints are better. Can you link this with your physiology knowledge? Why do you think once the patient is passing sedimentous urine, why do you think his joint affections are better? See, now I'll tell you, this is what I was trying to tell you. If you read this symptom just like that, rheumatism better after passing sedimentous urine. If you just read this as a statement, it will be boring. But if you understand why after passing sedimentous urine, he feels better, if you understand using your physiology knowledge, then materia will become very interesting. Somebody has given vaguely, but I take that point. See, uric acid, or when kidney starts functioning, you know, it eliminates lot of salts. Okay, so offensive, that sedimentous urine, kidney is trying to throw out uric acid. Fine. So the uric acid that is getting deposited in the joints, that uric acid gets passed out, or that will pass out through your urine. So there is no deposit of uric acid in the joint, so the joint feels comfortable. Are you getting my point? So please try and understand, learn Materia Medica like this, so that it remains, and it will be very interesting to read Materia Medica. Okay, valvular diseases, we saw that. See, now after rheumatism, I use the word metastasis. Fine. See, metastasis means transfer of disease from one part to another part. Metastasis is used mainly in cancer, but we can also use it in colchicum, not for cancer, but from joint, the disease will travel to heart. So this, what is it? Transfer from the joints to heart is metastasis. After joint, rheumatism is fine. They will have joint affections. Okay. So this is with the joints, very important. Frequently asked in your exams, either joint or either, JT for 5 marks, and kidney affections for 3 marks, mind for 3 marks. Okay. Now the last part will be the modalities. When the complaints are aggravated, you told me touch, you know the season, it is autumn, night, you know, sunset to sunrise, loss of sleep, smell of food, movement, all these things aggravate complaints in colchicum. These are called as general modalities. Now what ameliorates? Rest, I should have asked you this. Warmth, colchicum is a chilly patient. And what is better, doubling up? Can somebody quickly tell me? Doubling up. What is that complaint that gets better in colchicum when they double up? Doubling up means when they are bending their abdomen, or when they are bending their body forward. Very good. Amina, yes, beautiful. Colic pains are better by bending double. Very good, good. So this is the kind of clarity you need to have. Okay. So I hope colchicum is clear. Okay. So there were few questions. You can also start thinking of anything. I'll just look into the chat box. When I was explaining, there were a few questions that had come up. So let me just search for those questions. Yeah, 1 second. Sir, can it be given? Oh, where is this? Okay. Sir, can it be given for amoebic dysentery? When we get to know that the person has undergone the investigations done by an allopathic physician, because the nature of stools and more symptoms find to be similar to the symptoms under colchicum. See, absolutely right. Now, if you recall, I told you we have to read Materia Medica in association with pathology as a second year student, in association with Organon and forensic medicine. These are the three other subjects you have in your second year. See, when you read amoebic dysentery, you know, from the knowledge of pathology, what happens in amoebic dysentery, what the characteristic stools are. Okay, there are some common symptoms which you also saw in colchicum. But colchicum will have something very peculiar. The tenesmus, that stools, mucousy stools which are white, and that frequent urging, that pain, all those things. If you have all those things, then colchicum can get indicated. But it will not be a specific remedy for amoebic dysentery. We have many remedies. See, as a second year student, this is the only remedy that you know for time being. But as you grow, a lot of remedies keep
getting added, fine. And then you'll get the clarity. When colchicum, when nux vomica, when murk, when capsicum, when colocynth, when arsenic, when, yeah, murk. So this clarity you'll slowly start getting. But it's a good thought. Probably Neeraja has asked this question. Yes, it's a good thing. Yeah, I'll also look into it. The uric acid. Yeah, good. Okay. Any other questions you have or anything you'd like to ask? I have two more minutes. If you have any quick questions, we'll take it up.
Or I'll just try to sum up. Mind, though, I hope it is clear. We spoke of particulars, three areas we have given importance to. One is the GIT, second is the joints, and third is the kidneys. Okay, fine. And I'm happy that many of you could recall, and this was a very interactive class. Expecting the same in future classes also. So next class, I'll hopefully start with a remedy which is similar to colchicum, so that you'll also understand, and we can also start differentiating. Okay, and it will be fun. So thank you all for joining, and next Thursday or Friday, I'll keep you informed. We'll start with a new remedy. Thank you all.